Hello and welcome to the world of recipes. I'm Vaishali and today I'm going to show you how to make Maharashtra's famous street food batata vada. This is also called as alu bunda. Whenever you travel in Maharashtra, you cannot resist yourself without trying it. Nowadays you get it all over India and even outside India. This dish is mainly famous in Maharashtra. So today I'm going to show you how to make it in Maharashtrian style. So let's see the ingredients.
For making stuffing of batata vada, we need potato 1 kg. These are boiled and mashed potatoes.
2 medium sized onions chopped. 8 to 10 green chilies. 6 to 8 garlic cloves. Handful of coriander.
Fennel seed 1 tablespoon. Coriander seeds 1 tablespoon. Cumin seed 1/2 tablespoon. Salt 1/2 tablespoon. Turmeric powder 1 teaspoon. For making covering of batata vada, we need chickpea flour 2 cups, salt about 1/2 tablespoon, ajwain or carom seed teaspoon or 1/2 teaspoon baking soda.
Oil for frying. Let's start with the preparation now.
First, dry roast this fennel seeds, coriander seeds and cumin seeds for 1 or 2 minutes. Once you start getting the aroma of the seeds, turn off the flame. Let them cool down and grind them roughly.
I have roughly ground these spices. No need to make fine powder of this. We need to get those bites of these spices in our batata vada. It gives nice and crunchy taste to it. Now we'll remove this in a plate and we'll in the same jar we'll take green chilies and garlic cloves and we'll grind them for a fine paste. Now we have ground this garlic and chilies also.
Add oil to the pan. I'm adding about 1 tablespoon of oil here. Adding onions to the oil. Cook these onions till it becomes light brown in color. Now this onion has turned brown. Now we'll add in this chili and garlic paste. Mix it well. I have used 7 to 8 green chilies here because in this recipe we are not adding any red chili powder. So whatever spiciness of this filling will be with the green chilies only. You can adjust the number of green chilies according to your taste. As the green chilies are roasted, we have added this coriander, cumin and soft powder to this. These are already roasted, so we don't need to roast it more. Now immediately add these potatoes. Mix it well with all the spices. Now these potatoes are mixed with all the spices well. Now we'll sprinkle a tablespoon of gram flour over it. And this is the trick for getting nice binding for the filling. And this gram flour will improve the taste of batata vada just like dhaba style batata vada.
Add in salt as per your taste.
Mix it well. Now we'll cover the pan and let this mixture cook for about 5 minutes to remove the rawness of chickpea flour. After 5 minutes, this chickpea flour is roasted properly. Now we'll add in handful of coriander leaves here. Now we'll turn off the flame and let this potato mixture cool down completely. By that time we'll make a batter for covering. To this chickpea flour we will add salt and ajwain. Mix it well. And now we'll add in water and make a batter. We need little thick batter here. Batter is ready. We want this thick batter. Now this potato mix is cooled down. Now we'll take handful of mix in our hands and we'll make balls. You can make the size of balls according to the batata vada size you want. Same way I will make all the balls and keep it.
Balls are ready. With 1 kg of potato we have made around 17 to 18 balls
and this batter is also ready. Just before frying these balls, we need to add baking soda to this batter and mix it well. We have to beat this mixture very nicely to get that fluffy covering for the patata vada. I will beat it about 1 or 2 minutes. Now this batter is ready. Let's start frying. We have kept the oil for frying now. Now this oil is ready for frying. Let's check. Yes, this batter is immediately coming up, so it's ready. Now we'll take these potato balls, dip it in the batter, cover it from all the sides properly. And just drop it in the oil. You can fry 5 to 6 patata vadas at a time. Make sure you have taken enough oil for these patata vadas to sink in. Then only it will be fried evenly from all the sides. Now we are frying it on the medium heat. We need to fry them till it becomes light golden in color from all the sides. Now you can see this patata vadas has turned little golden in color. That means it's cooked. Let's take it out from the oil. Drain out excess oil. You can serve this patata vada with any kind of chutney. You can use this patata vada in making vada pav, or you can serve it with a special kind of curry also, that is a gravy. Enjoy this patata vada or aloo ponda. And do subscribe to my channel to get more interesting recipes like this. And please press the bell icon to get notifications for new uploads. Thanks for watching this recipe. Thank you.